Ora, sejam muito bem-vindos a mais um episódio de FIFA Realism, com os nossos modos realistas. Estamos no mercado de inverno. Entramos no vencer, vencemos o Brentford por 3-1 e agora recebemos o Leicester. Estamos a preparar já este jogo em muito pouco tempo, só temos 3 dias. Portanto, pelo menos fazer uma sessão em conjunto para elevar aqui os níveis de sharpness neste mercado de inverno. Aí está, United quer contratar Camará. Vamos aceitar. A ideia é limpar este plantel, que bem precisamos. Entrar em estágio e vamos para o jogo frente ao Leicester. A equipa fisicamente está aceitável, o que é muito bom. E vamos manter o 11 da última jornada. Jogámos bem e estamos em boa forma. Entramos muito bem no ano e é com esta equipa que nós vamos para o jogo. Tempo limpo, ótimo. Enfrentar aqui o Leicester não será fácil, mas vamos tentar aqui manter esta boa vibe do último jogo, boas sensações. E vamos lá para o jogo e falamos novamente ao intervalo. Até já.
Hello to you, wherever you happen to be. Our action comes to you today from Villa Park. I'm your match commentator, Derek Ray, and my partner, ready to bring you all the analysis and technical talk, is Stuart Robson. I'm looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League coming right up. It's Aston Villa against Leicester City.
Thanks, Derek. Well, both managers will be reminding their players of starting the game quickly, hitting the opposition back, playing the ball forward, and regaining possession as quickly as possible. Hopefully, we get a really good game here.
Here's how the lineup looks for Aston Villa.
Good luck.
Cheers.
Thanks.
Hi.
Good game.
Good game.
Good game. Hey, good game.
Thanks. Good.
And the lineup for Leicester City.
Well, in this shape, their two holding midfield players will be key today. If they can get on the ball and dictate the play, protect the two centre backs, it will then allow the attacking players to show their creative quality.
Thank you, Villa Park. Enjoy the game.
And the match begins. Not what he was intending. Bad pass. Boubacary Soumaré. And a fine tackle. Can he play it in? And this might not be the ideal situation for them. There it is, and just the ideal start.
Well, as the replay shows, this is all about his ability to find space in the box, which then makes the finish look so much easier. That's good play from him.
So the ball rolling again, with the scoreline standing at 1-0. Boubacar Camara. And now with Moreno. Good use of advantage by the referee. But it didn't end up being a significant advantage. And so a free kick here. Opportunity to deliver the cross. And overcame the ball from the flank, but dealt with in the end. Boubacary Soumaré. Costa did well to win the ball back. Steffi Mabedidi. Now options are plenty, and reading it absolutely superbly. Clear foul play, and as a result, a free kick forthcoming. Iheanacho. Can he finish this? He got in the way of that cross. Great strong tackle. Throw in forthcoming. Perfect tackle. Kieran Dewsbury Hall. Leicester being afforded too much space here. Options in the centre. And it's Winks. Soumaré. Iheanacho. And a goal to increase their advantage. It's a two-goal lead now.
Just look at this again. The combination play in the top third of the field was so precise. And from there, he never looked like missing. That's a lovely goal.
So back underway with the lead standing at 2-0. John McGinn. Torres on the ball. Douglas Luiz. Plenty of options. McGinn. Could cross it in here. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. That was miles off target. Challenge, and the referee has got to have a big think about it. And a yellow card for that, Stuart.
And he's going to have to be careful now. That was a silly challenge.
Boubacar Camara. Serginho Dest. Who can he pick out? And the referee blows the whistle. It is a free kick. And a useful cross. Well, they couldn't take advantage of the opportunity. Well, a clear foul, but the referee letting the play flow. Winks. Soumaré on the ball. Decent position. and whipped into the box. That's all they can conjure for now. Well, the referee wasn't going to let that go. And he'll go back and hand out a yellow card here.
Yeah, he was always going to go back for that challenge. It was a poor one, you have to say.
Diaby. Going well. Very quick thinking there. Douglas Luiz. Magnificent challenge to win it back. Mabedidi. Nicely timed tackle. Could be a chance to break here. Iheanacho. And lining it up. Oh, a vital interception. Well, if you're going to challenge like that, it has to be spot on. What did the referee think of it? And the red card has been shown, and that puts a bit of a stain on things.
Well, they're in a great position, but that could change everything. It's a thoughtless challenge.
Alex Moreno. Chance to play it in. Douglas Luiz. It's with Camara. Diego Carlos. I must say, this looks promising. Christiansen.
Well, as those stats show us, Leicester haven't been able to control the possession, but what they've done with it has been really good, and they'll be happy with the way the game is being played at the moment. They love to play on the counter-attack.
Be onto something. Real chance. That really would have changed the equation had it gone in, Stuart.
Well, he needed to score there. That may just have given them some hope.
Now the pass not finding its target. Effective shielding under pressure. Harry Souter. Dewsbury Hall.
Well, they're being outplayed here, and the fans are not happy. They need to show more urgency now.
And still pressing. And let's give credit to the defending. Well, a last-ditch challenge, but there's always an element of risk about it, and we wonder what the referee is going to do next. Well, not a red card, just a yellow. Interesting one, Stuart.
Well, I have to say, I think the referee's got that absolutely right. I don't think it was a red card. I'm not sure it was a goal.
Now, this could really lift spirits. And that's an excellent piece of defending to thwart him. Well, the counter chance looks very real. Well, a really single-minded piece of defending to make sure nothing untoward happened. Pau Torres. And now with McGinn. Well, the attack looks promising. It needs an accurate cross. Not able to put it behind for what will be a corner here.
Well, these fans can sense an opportunity here. They need to make the most of this corner.
Playing it in. Oh, really sound goalkeeping.
Well, that's such a good save, isn't it? How did he keep that one out? Well, here it is again. It's a well-delivered ball into the box, and then what a great finish as well. Good connection with the ball, leaving the keeper with little chance. It's a great goal.
So back underway at 2-1. Tight contest here. Steffi Mabadidi. Under pressure. Doesn't seem to be bothering him. And he successfully got past him. Not a bad ball. Absolutely nothing wrong with the idea, but no end product. Iheanacho. Well, there we have it. That's going to be all for the first half here in the Midlands. Well, he's been a long way from his best up front, Stuart.
Yeah, he's not played well, has he? He's just failed to have an impact.
Bem, neste caso aqui o comentador está certo. Zaniol está a fazer um jogo muito mau. Teve já três oportunidades excelentes para fazer golo e não conseguiu acertar na baliza. Jogando contra 10, eles estão-se a fechar muito bem, é verdade. Aqui, por agora, ainda não vou fazer nenhuma alteração assim de relevo. Vamos primeiro, nos primeiros 10 minutos, vamos manter assim. E depois sim, vamos começar a mudar algumas peças, tendo em conta também as cartas que podemos jogar no caso não conseguirmos chegar à igualdade e ir atrás do resultado. Portanto, por agora vai assim, vamos ver como é que corre. Até aos 55 para ver como é que o Neto ali também fisicamente vai continuando a comportar-se e vamos ver então como é que é a segunda parte. Até já.
So back in business, Leicester with the lead, but this game far from being done and dusted. Foul there, free kick awarded. Well, sometimes in football we take rumours with a pinch of salt, but occasionally the rumours are true, and it could be that Manchester United are about to add to their squad.
Yes, Derek, the figure we've been hearing is around about £35 million, which I believe is a good offer for a player with his kind of talent. Will Villa let him go at that price? We'll know in the next couple of days.
Diego Carlos. And now with Moreno. Now, let's see what they can do here. Douglas Luiz. Showing patience as well as persistence in the build-up. And the cross goes in. And still dangerous. Douglas Luiz. And now with McGinn. And played the pass well. Now delivering that deep cross. Oh, he squandered the chance, and he knows it.
Well, it wouldn't have counted anyway. He was offside, but nonetheless, that was a poor attempt.
Now, this is the home of live football, and we'll have live coverage of the third round of the FA Cup for you. It's Aston Villa facing West Bromwich Albion.
Well, it's great to have a break from the league for the players and the fans. Everybody loves this competition, and so do I. It should be a good game.
Pedro Neto. Good tackle. It'll be a throw. Crossing opportunity. Nicely timed tackle. Iheanacho. Failed to keep hold of it. Alex Moreno. Well, that's a super ball over the top. Opportunity, maybe. Well, the keeper had plenty to think about with bodies around him.
Well, the stats don't lie. Their general build-up play has been good. They've carved out several opportunities, but their shooting has been way below par. That needs to change, and it needs to change quickly.
Played into the centre. Well, a bit short with the clearance. And problem solved for now. Winks. This looks promising. Winks. And now, passing it through. Almost found its target, but cutting it out in the end. Well, this is the home of live football, and we'll have live coverage of the third round of the FA Cup for you. It's Leicester City facing Fulham.
Well, the cup always whets the appetite, and that one's no different. It should be a really good game.
And Villa with the ball again. Neto. In position. Well, goodness me, into the goalkeeper's grateful grasp. And players waiting in the centre. That's well blocked. Deflected behind, corner forthcoming. Here it is now, a substitution.
Well, it's been a while, but these fans are now coming to life. Can they equalise here?
Trying to deliver it accurately. Clearing their lines, and so it will be a corner now. Who can he pick out? Oh, a very fine header, but it wouldn't go in for him. And he might be trailing, but hope in the form of a corner. Can someone get on the end of this? Well, far from the ideal header. And the goalkeeper had it all the way. Giving the ball away. Boubacar Camara. Looking position, you've got to say. And the cross comes to nothing in the end. Good pressure to win the ball back high up the pitch. Misfiring completely.
Yeah, he's gone for power, but the contact was never right. It's a poor effort, really.
Well, they have elected to go to the bench at this stage of the game. ...20 minutes to go in this one. Take it away.
With the owner of the blue card registration, BG04...
Dewsbury Hall.
Please turn your lights off.
Well, not hard to read that pass. Diaby. And they do like to press whenever they can. Just hearing something has happened at Molineux. There's been a goal there, Alex Scott.
Yep, a second goal for the Gunners. It was a volley that was mishit. It totally fooled everyone, including the goalkeeper. They've pulled one back and now trail by one with 76 minutes played.
Thank you, Alex. He's in here. It's opened up for him. Oh, terrific save from the keeper.
Well, that's just a wonderful save. How did he stop that?
Who can they pick out? And he clears the danger. McGinn. Well, closed down straight away. Unable to keep the ball. Boubacar Camara. To an attacking position. It's not too late for them. It needs an accurate cross. But I'm hearing something important has happened in the Palace game. Let's find out what from Alex.
It's a goal for Newcastle. They've scored the opener here with 10 minutes left on the clock.
Thanks as always, Alex. Sergiño Dest. Diaby. A sloppy pass. Biraghi. Crossed in there. This could be the equaliser. Pivotal moment defensively. Well, it comes down to the final 5 minutes. Dewsbury Hall. Difficult to stop him. Favour the cross. Nicely timed tackle. And the counter looks on here. Options available. Will it be sufficiently imaginative? They might be able to get in now. Well, the flag was up in good time, bringing that move to an end.
He's just got to be more patient there. He's gone too early.
And a substitution in the offing. Kieran Dewsbury Hall. He's in control of the situation. Oh, tremendous goalkeeping. But hang on, offside is the decision here. McGinn. Now here's Biraghi. Martial. They are making headway, but really they need a goal with time not on their side. Martial. And with that, the attack fizzles out. And good use of advantage, the referee allowing play to continue. A terrific pass. Now, will they do it from here? What great excitement! And the match is level.
Well, here it is again. He goes past his marker so easily with just a drop of the shoulder. And what a clinical finish this is from Martial. He hits it with such power. That's a good goal.
And the referee brings this contest to an end. It certainly was pulsating. It had us on the edge of our seats. Stuart, your take.
Well, it was excellent entertainment. We saw good quality football played at a high intensity and goals as well. The draw is a fair reflection of how the game was played.
And it's Winks. Sumare.
Bem, que sofrimento. E vejam bem isto, dois remates, dois golos, foi o que eles fizeram na primeira parte e depois não fizeram mais nada. Ok, tiveram uma expulsão, é verdade, tentaram segurar essa vantagem, mas as conclusões que se tiram é que não se pode entrar então assim nos jogos com as falhas que tivemos, mas mesmo ao cair do pano, em cima do... dos segundos finais dos descontos, Martial a dar o empate. Aqui está, talvez por, só por causa desse gol é que teve esta classificação, porque a nível geral não foi positivo. E até mais, Dewsbury Hall foi então o homem do jogo. É pena, era uma oportunidade excelente para ganharmos mais 3 pontos. Não perdemos, é verdade, mas temos que fazer mais. Vamos então à flash.
Time for a few questions.
Ok. Se nos sentimos que tivemos sorte a obter este empate no final. E esta é que é a verdade, precisamos é de começar os jogos melhor. É exatamente isto. Nós na primeira volta vencemos o Leicester. E o futebol não é sempre previsível, portanto não... esperamos ganhar todos os jogos, mas isso não quer dizer que aconteça. Ficamos apontados por termos saído a chuva apenas com o empate. Temos que aprender dos nossos erros, essa que é a verdade, fizemos algumas coisas boas, mas eles fazerem 2 remates e marcando 2 golos não pode acontecer. Tentativa de recuperação. Vamos ter aqui então uma saída e pelo visto é Camará, está para o Man United, 44 milhões. Parece-me um bom negócio, até porque há bastantes alternativas para aquela posição e Mesbury também vai sair. Agora do jogador aceitar ou não, mas está em aberto, Isto quer dizer que poderá haver aqui mudanças. Poderá jogar Douglas Luiz a trinco e da Donker mais um pouco acima. Mesbury também em princípio irá sair. Estamos a aguardar o regresso de Tillmans, que não será para esta época. E como tal, eu acho que é agora que faz sentido ir ao mercado e buscar um médio que faça transporte de bola, que seja criativo e que dê aquele elemento ao meio-campo que nós não temos nestes jogadores por agora, pelo menos de uma forma madura. Temos aqui a bom preço o Enzo, o Loia disse. É playmaker, não é rápido, mas tem boa stamina, bom ball control, bom drible, é jovem, também nos desarmes é bom. Há essa hipótese. Temos aqui Engels, 21 anos, belga, mas era necessário uma maior evolução. Depois temos aqui Alain, do Flamengo, posto de força, e depois, claro, craques. Temos Sabitzer, que seria muito interessante. Temos Giovanni Lo Celso, mas não é aquele jogador do meio campo, é mais jogador para deixar livre. E também a Real Sociedade não vende, tínhamos de pagar a cláusula que são 82 milhões de euros, não me parece. Portanto, eu acho que vou avançar para Marcel Sabitzer. Será um bom elemento para completar ali o meio campo. Vamos tentar então oferecer à volta dos 23,5, a ver se conseguimos convencer o jogador. Portanto, vamos oferecer 23,5. A ver o que é que dizem. Agora estão a pedir 26,100, uma cláusula de venda futura de 5%. Se querem a cláusula de venda futura, eu vou reduzir após 24.800. Vamos ver. 25.5. Então, meio caminho. 25. E está feito. 30 anos. 25 milhões. Está feito. Vamos então negociar com Marcel Sabitzer. Mais um reforço para nos ajudar a tentar chegar aos 4 primeiros da Premier League. Vamos então. Isso é importante, claro que sim, faz sentido. Contrato 3 anos, acho que é importante. Sim senhora, tem 30 anos, já não vai haver cláusula de rescisão. Salário, vamos reduzir aqui um bocadinho, mas eu compenso com um bom bónus, 350 mil, e por aqui golos. marcares 10 golos, 200 mil. O que é que acham? Está feito? Sabitzer. Dá outras opções e quando tiver Tillman disponível, mas já será na próxima época, poderá ser um meio-campo muito forte, tanto fisicamente como a nível de qualidade de passe e de remate exterior. Aí está Sabitzer. Vamos ver o que é que ele pode trazer. A verdade é que faz parte, está connosco. Vamos então aqui ao planeamento para Sabitzer. Aqui a trabalhar físico. Já tem 30 anos. Chega ao clube. Não estará ainda nas melhores condições para ser titular, mas sem dúvida que quero que faça parte das escolhas do banco. Está, salvamos e vamos ficar por aqui. No próximo episódio então, visita ao West Bromwich para a FA Cup, portanto também é uma oportunidade para fazermos alguma rotação, e sendo assim, no próximo episódio fazemos este jogo e vamos anunciar mais novidades no mercado de transferências neste mercado de inverno. Da minha parte é tudo, obrigado por terem assistido ao vídeo, já sabem, like and subscribe, ajudem o canal e a gente vê-se na próxima. Grande abraço!